How to read and analyze a balance sheet. This balance sheet tutorial is a companion video to how to read an annual report, how to read an income statement, and how to read a cash flow statement, and covers the 2017 balance sheet of Alphabet Inc., the parent company of, amongst others, Google. The balance sheet is a fascinating financial statement. You can learn a lot from it about the state of health of a company. Learning to read a balance sheet takes practice, practice, and practice, and some understanding of the key terminology. You have come to the right place for that. The balance sheet is an overview of what the company owns and what the company owes at a specific point in time. In this case study, December 31st, 2017. When I analyze a balance sheet, there are several things I always check for each company I look at. The balance sheet total, which should be the same left and right, what a company owns equals to what the company owes. The current ratio, a good indicator of a company's liquidity. And equity as a percentage of the balance sheet total, which gives an indication of how the company is financed and what its level of robustness is. Then I look specifically at several items on the asset side and several items on the liabilities and equity side. What those specific items are, I only decide after taking a first look at the balance sheet of the company under review. It depends on the context. As always on the Finance Storyteller channel, this video is for educational purposes only. None of the comments in this video should be interpreted as investment advice. As the video is for educational purposes, please do try this at home and comment on your findings below. In order to analyze the balance sheet, you need to download the annual report. In the case of Alphabet Inc., go to abc.xyz/investor and download the 10K PDF version. Scroll down the table of contents of the 10K annual report up to item 8. Financial statements and supplementary data. Click on the link. You now arrive at the index to the financial statements and the related notes. Click on Consolidated Balance Sheets. Here's the assets side of Alphabet Inc.'s balance sheet for year-end 2016 on the left and year-end 2017 on the right. The balance sheet total is large, $197.3 billion in 2017. It is also significantly bigger than last year's balance sheet total. Both in the income statement that we reviewed previously, as well as the balance sheet, Alphabet Inc. is growing considerably. To select specific items for further review, I look at the absolute size of the line items, the movement, increase or decrease versus prior year, and the risk level associated with the item. On the asset side, more than half of the total assets sit in cash, cash equivalents, and marketable securities, $101.9 billion. Up more than $15 billion versus the year before, worth taking a look at in more detail. Property and equipment is $42.4 billion, up over $8 billion versus prior year. Lastly, goodwill is $16.7 billion, up only slightly versus prior year, but significant in absolute terms. Cash, cash equivalents and marketable securities, $101.9 billion in total. Not as big as on Apple's balance sheet, but still one of the largest balances in the corporate world. Note 3 to the Alphabet Inc. financial statements provides details of where that balance is invested. $36.9 billion in US government notes, $24.2 billion in corporate debt securities, $11 billion in mortgage-backed securities. The cash, cash equivalents and marketable securities portfolio generated an interest income of $1.3 billion in 2017. Recorded in other income in the income statement. If Alphabet Inc. wants to make any significant incremental investments in their business, either for organic growth or growth through acquisition, they have the money ready. These are very liquid investments, easily convertible to cash. Property and equipment. The balance of property and equipment was $42.4 billion at year-end 2017, up $8.1 billion versus year-end 2016. In the cash flow statement analysis, we saw that the CapEx cash outflow in cash from investing activities was $13.2 billion in 2017. The major balance sheet components in the property and equipment balance at the end of 2017 were land and buildings, $23.2 billion, information technology assets, $21.4 billion, and construction in progress, $10.5 billion. While the gross value of property and equipment has gone up significantly, the accumulated depreciation has also increased, as the value of the assets in use is allocated to the years of usage. Goodwill. One of my favorite items to review on a balance sheet, as it tells a lot about the way the company has grown over the years. A high goodwill balance is an indication of significant acquisition activity in the company's history. Goodwill is the excess of the purchase price paid for acquired firms over the fair value of its separately identifiable net assets. Goodwill can be a major risk item on the company's balance sheet if the performance of the acquired company does not live up to expectations. An impairment, one-time write-off, might then be needed of part of the goodwill. In the case of Alphabet Inc., the goodwill balance at year-end 2017 is $16.7 billion, which is up only relatively slightly compared to the last year and the year before. Yes, a few hundred million dollars qualifies as slightly in the context of Alphabet Inc. To find a more significant increase in the goodwill balance, you have to go back to the 2014 annual report. In 2014, goodwill went up more than $4 billion from $11.5 billion at the start of the year to $15.6 billion at the end of the year. $2.3 billion due to the Nest acquisition, $452 million for the Dropcam acquisition, $388 million for the Skybox acquisition, and $1 billion for other acquisitions that year. Going through the history of Alphabet Inc.'s acquisitions feels like a technological journey through time and gives an indication of the breadth of the portfolio. Time to check on our progress on the balance sheet analysis. So far, we have been able to check the balance sheet total on the asset sides and reviewed in more detail selected asset items such as cash and marketable securities, property and equipment, and goodwill. Now it's time to turn to the other side of the balance sheet to review liabilities and equity. What a company owns, assets, has to equal what the company owes, liabilities and equity. So our first check here is that the total at the bottom of the page is $197.3 billion. Within that total, by far the biggest amount is in equity, shareholder capital, $152.5 billion, or 70% of the total. That's unusually high in both absolute and relative terms, but makes the company very robust. Within equity, nearly three quarters is in retained earnings. As Alphabet Inc. is very profitable, has historically not paid a dividend to its shareholders, and does not expect to pay any cash dividends in the foreseeable future, this retained earnings balance keeps on growing and growing. In comparison to the equity balance, all other line items on this page seem tiny, even though in absolute terms they might still be sizable. Two items jump out, as they are larger than $10 billion at year-end 2017, and because the balance has gone up significantly year over year. Income taxes payable and accrued expenses and other liabilities. Let's review what is going on there. Income taxes payable. The details on this balance sheet liability account are not directly given to us in the Alphabet Inc. annual report, but there are other ways to get an idea of what is going on. What you see here is the overview of the provision for income taxes in the income statement. $14.5 billion in total in 2017, much higher than in previous years. The vast majority of the amount, and the majority of the increase, is from federal and state taxes. The narrative at the bottom of the page explains the impact of the US Tax Act of December 2017. In the case of Alphabet Inc., the main item having an impact in 2017 was the one-time transition tax, which was recorded as a debit to income tax expense in the income statement, but as it was not paid yet in cash, the credit went to the liability account called income taxes payable on the balance sheet. The December 31st, 2016 and December 31st, 2017 balances, as well as the main line items for accrued expenses and other liabilities, are shown in a note to the financial statements. The European Commission fine of $2.9 billion stands out here. This is the fine that the European Commission has announced, which Alphabet is appealing and has not paid yet. Alphabet Inc. has recorded the fine as an expense, debit, in the income statement, and the offset, credit, to that journal entry was accrued expenses and other liabilities. In other words, the expenses are recorded, but the settlement or payment has not occurred. Time for a progress check on our balance sheet analysis. So far, we have been able to check the balance sheet total on the asset side, looked at equity as a percentage of the balance sheet total, and reviewed in more detail selected asset and liability items. Now it's time to connect both sides of the balance sheet. Assets, what a company owns, and liabilities and equity, what a company owes, to see the bigger picture. The current ratio is one of the ways to connect both sides of the balance sheet. The current ratio looks at current assets versus current liabilities. Current assets are things that are already cash or are likely to become cash within 12 months. Current liabilities are things that need to be paid in cash within 12 months. If the current ratio is high, then that means that the company has a high liquidity. In the case of Alphabet Inc., the current ratio is very high at 514%, 124.3 billion in current assets, over 24.2 billion in current liabilities. For every $1 in current liabilities, $5.40 in current assets. If Alphabet Inc. owes you money, they are highly likely to be able to pay you. We have succeeded in performing a high-level balance sheet analysis of Alphabet Inc. by focusing on five areas: balance sheet totals, current ratio, equity as percentage of the total, and selected items in assets and liabilities. I'm very interested to hear your comments. Please post them below the video. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this explanation of how to read a balance sheet and how to perform a balance sheet analysis, then please give it a thumbs up. On this end screen, there are a few suggestions of videos you can watch next. Please subscribe to the Finance Storyteller YouTube channel. Thank you.